Hi everybody, this is Patty. I'm here today with a design team project for Country Craft Creations. And I wanted to show you, I used the Cafe Parisian 8x8 and 6x6 paper packs that Tammy Merrill had sent me from the store. Now, you can see I still have quite a bit of the 6x6 left. I've probably used about half of it. But this 8x8 pad, I have one sheet left in. I've used some of the packaging. And this is all I have left. One large sheet, two large sheets, and just these little scraps. And I'm now in the process of making some cards. And then I have a few pieces of chipboard. So I did pretty well using up the what she had sent. And this is what I made. This is, let me measure for you. This is 8.5 by 8.5 mini album. And it's made out of chipboard. It has a, I believe, 3.5 inch spine. Yes, I'll just leave that ruler there. 3.5 inch spine. This is covered with Elizabeth Craft's cream color because I had this paper left over in my stash and I wanted to use it up, and I did. I used it all up. But I did have problems. It's not like Tammy's artisan paper. I did have a little bit of cracking on the spine here when I got all done, which is just heartbreaking. But I covered it with this really pretty lace that my niece had given me. And this particular line, you know, makes you think of tablecloths and aprons and whatever. So this just kind of made me feel like a tablecloth effect. This is some lace Tammy sent me, oh, months ago from the store, and I don't know if she has it anymore. And then she sent me the colored seam binding. And I did this several times, weaving the seam binding through the lace. This is a handmade charm that came from the store. And then on the back, you can see I've just used one of the full sheets, part of the cut aparts, and one of the chipboard on the back, and glued the lace down. Now I have to share with you, I bought the large bottle of designer art glitter glue, plus I have the small bottles. And this was an experiment because I've listened to the people in the Facebook group, and I've listened to Tammy say that some of them are only using the glue. So the only thing I used on this book was the art glitter glue. Now that includes gluing the cover to the chipboard. That includes my spine. That includes my hinges. The only other thing that I have other than this is a little bit of foam tape to pop things up. So far, I even glued my lace, which I never ever do. I always use Fabri-Tac. And I glued my lace, and I have to, and my charm, my bows, everything with this. And I gotta tell you, so far, I am really impressed. It really does work on a multitude of crafting medium. Okay, I did this a little bit different. I took the two pages that were identical in the 8x8 book. And then I took the one, and it is my back. And now can you see there? See this glisten? Okay, that is a piece of Heartfelt Creations acrylic page. And I cut it to fit and glued it over the top. I think I did use score tape on that. I can't remember, but that'd be the only place I used it. Then I took the other piece and I fussy cut it. And you can see, okay, here. See, you can see all of this is fussy cut out and here and around. And I like doing this. If you don't like doing it, I don't suggest it, because if it's something that really bugs you, this is going to be a tedious, yucky project, and you would not be happy. But I did this at the very beginning, so it was just sitting back waiting to put on my book when I was done. And I love the dimensional look to this now. It looks like these gals are behind the glass. The one serving is in front of it. It's just a real neat effect for the front of the book. Now here, can you, oh, there, can you see on the umbrella over the stripes? Here, I'm trying to get there. The stripes, so you can do them. The cherries are a glitter, two-tone glitter here, and then I have the bows. Okay, so there's the outside. Now, when you open it up, it is four long pages and a couple half pages. So 5 pages in all. It has half inch gussets between them. And I did glue the paper down, which I don't normally do, and I see that it's crunching over, so I may have to take that paper up and glue a smaller one on. The front inside cover is more of this lace that I got from Tammy's shop with the colored seam binding ribbon woven through, and I tied it on both ends and glued it down again with the art glitter glue. I made a pocket across the bottom. This was my most challenging thing because I wanted this big cluster, so I took 4 pieces in fact, because this is chipboard, a piece, the two gals and the dogs from the paper line. This is actually from the front or the back, the front cover of the book, I believe. And then I just put them all together to create this pocket across the bottom. I did cut out, I think I have 3 or 4 of these. I cut these out on my Big Shot with a, I think it's a Little Bees die. And they're just for pictures front and back. But the problem was, if you don't have something like this here, then it just falls out. So I wanted something that would be a stopper. I put another one up here, and you can see I took 3D crystal accents, and I went over the cherries almost, and the little, it looks like a brad here, but it's really punched from the paper. And then I just have these mats that go underneath and go in, and it slides underneath the lace because I left the lace free there. And then this one slides in like this, and it will slide only as far as the stopper now. Now the fun thing is here, and I didn't want to put this on the outside of the book because I was afraid it might come up, but I took a piece of wire, like jewelry wire, and it has this little loop on it. I put some down, some glossy accents, let it get a little tacky, then I put the wire into it, put my stickles over the top so they're glued between two, and now I've got that neat little stem to the cherry. I just love it. On the butterfly, I fussed it, cut it out from the paper and applied, I think I used the 3D crystal lacquer again. Now on the first page, I've got a pocket here, and I have another piece of chipboard. This acts as a stopper so things don't fall again. I have a chipboard piece here, and I've just attached 2 pieces of the ribbon and glued it flat to the book. Again, I used the lace from Tammy's store and put the seam binding woven through it. And this is gusseted. So you have like a half inch space here. I ended up gluing it down on this side, but I let this side free. So you could put bunches of photos inside here because you've got lots of room. And I just have a little paper clip that my friend Ange sent me. And I just have it attached here on the side with some seam binding. So that's that one. And then when you go here, I have on this 2 pages, I try to carry it through on both sides so it flows. And get that out of the way here. And then on this one, I created a pocket at the front. So it pulls out. It has some of the little ladies attached. And a lot of things that had anything like this, I don't know if you're going to see the shimmer. Let's see if you can see it on this one, on this round here. Going to get it way up close, and I'm just going to turn it a little. It's so hard sometimes to see, but this is Tattered Angels Glimmer Mist in the iridescent gold, and I use this throughout the book on any of the chipboard pieces like this that I had cut out, because when you look at it, it has this glistening, shimmering look to it. It's gorgeous in real life. Now this pullout is just a piece I cut from the top here. I applied one of the chipboard buttons and a little piece of the seam binding in it, and then this just slides in from the top like this, and that will hold big pictures. And then when you line it up, it basically just continues the top of the book. Here, there's just a stopper here with this piece of chipboard and 3 tags that go in. Again, I used a bow of the seam binding. Tammy sent me 3 colors, the peach, the tealy blue, and a cream. And I've used all but just a little bitty piece of that is in the book. Now, on this side, this is a 12-inch piece of paper. And I scored it at 8, and then I scored it again at 8 and an eighth. So I have an eighth of an inch here, so it will just expand and open up. And when you open it, there's room for journaling on the front here. And then I have, this is from the outside of the packaging. And then I created a pocket. Now my brads don't go all the way through. They're just kind of fake. They're back behind here. And if you do that idea with the brads, make sure you cover the back of it with some Scotch tape, because that will allow it not to snag when you put your things in it. We have a postcard, another one of these mats like I have over here. And just, these are the journaling cards. I used almost all of those in this book. I just love it. I want the postcard to say so, show. So here I have another pocket. Again, I did the same thing with here. And these are cut, I don't have it here with me. Yes, I do. I cut them with a 2.5 inch corner rounder. And you just do a half punch into your paper and punch it out. And again, I put the button on it with the seam binding to carry it through. And it just slides in. When it slides right in the spot that you cut it out from. I like that effect. And then this just goes over, and then we're on the next page. Here, now I really like, let me see, here's the seam binding. Okay, you've got your seam binding, but I wanted something else. So I think I have, bear with me just a minute and see if I have, here, I have a strip. Because you, if you follow me at all, you know I save all these pieces until I'm through making cards, because even little pieces like this can be used. So what I did was, again, I took the art glitter glue, and you probably want to put it on a silicone mat so it doesn't stick to paper or anything, and you glue whatever your middle part is going to be down to the seam binding in the middle of it. Let it dry, then you put another layer of glue where you want this to be. Now see here, you can see this is my corner pocket. So I've glued it tight on both sides, wrapped it underneath the paper so the edges are hidden, and this creates the pocket and the stopper for my mats, and it's using the seam binding and a scrap piece of the paper. Love that effect. Let me get up there close so you can see it. Love that effect. And then I just tied a little bow and glued it right around the ribbon so it created that illusion of it being ribbon. On this side, I cut my hinge in half and I took about 1/4 inch out of it right here in the middle. Right there. So now I have two small flips. And on this one, I glued one of the pockets. I did use a decorative punch on this, and this is a Martha Stewart Deco Fan punch. I have used it in that one and the corresponding corner punch in areas. So I used the corner punch on it, and then I have a tag that I cut out of the paper, and then I had this solid blue that is the perfect color. But you know, I only had one little scrap, so I was only able to do these couple of tags. I was so disappointed, but I've hunted everywhere and couldn't find any more. So that goes in there. These two slide back behind here, and this one goes in the front of it. And then you turn that one over, and on the back of it, I have another pocket with one of the journaling cards and two of the small ones in the pocket. Great. But now when you're putting your pictures in, you could easily put a picture here, and you could use the front and the back of these for pictures if you wanted to. You don't have to leave it with what it is. Now on this one, I have a pocket across the top here, and this is a piece of the chipboard that I attach to it like a file folder. Now you can see this peachy edge here. What that is, let me get this out of the way so it's not distracting. What it is I wanted this on this side, but it extended above what my little flippy-doo was. So I just backed it, and now you have this pretty peach background. Nobody notices. You don't even think anything about it. And then this just slides in the pocket here, and this is where I use the corner punch. And on this side, I didn't do anything. I just put it on as a decorative element because I think it's so neat. On here, I have one of the pieces, the large journaling cards that form the pocket. And then I took the others, two of the other journaling cards, and I just folded them in half. I inked them all the way around, and they create two little ones that just slip inside here. And then I have one of the chipboard pieces with some of two of the colors of the seam binding. This is magnetic here. Again, I use that decorative punch, and it flips up and it flips down. And I didn't put anything on top or bottom, so pictures or journaling or whatever can go on this. And then I have two mats back behind for large, large photos on this one. And again, you can do a photo here, two here, two here. So you got five photos, six, and seven, or you can put a mat across and do journaling down here. And then it just snaps back in place. There is room in here, and I haven't, well, did I? Yes. I put a little mat in here. There is a pocket that I left. But if you don't want the pocket, you could always just glue it together. Okay, on these two pages, I have a side pocket with the journaling card, and I took two of them, because I think you get two of each in the package, and I fussy cut the flowers out, and I popped them up, so they're only glued in the middle, and the rest is free. They're inked really heavily around the outside, and I sprayed them again with the glimmery mist. And then this creates a pocket with two large mats back behind. And these mats coordinate. They are the same mats I used on this page. This is a belly band, and it does have a gusset on both sides, so you could put a lot of pictures in it. This is free down here. If you were worried about your photos falling out, you could attach it, and then they wouldn't be able to go any further. I didn't do that, but you can. Two more mats here. Then this one turns, and I have a strip with a piece of chipboard and some of the sentiments from the paper, and then this creates a pocket here with lots of little goodies. I have a little booklet here. I have just a plain 6x6 map here for pictures. Then I have a little one and a little one that go in, that just tuck in the pocket. I'm going to pull that up so you can see the writing on it. There we go. There. And I like the idea of the chipboard down here. It just kind of finishes it. Again, I have used the lace with the seam binding through it. This is a pocket. My friend Paula had made these on her Cricut, and she sent them to me. And I still had one I hadn't used, so I got it out and used it as a pattern to make my own pocket. And it's a fake pocket because it only has paper on the back to about here, and then the front part. And it is glued directly to the book. And then you can put mats. I have a little booklet in here, like this, and like this. And this is just using the front and back of the journaling cards. Very easy. And it slides in there. But if you had a favorite recipe, if you had ticket stubs, if you had some kind of memento, if you had a private photo that you wanted not the whole world to see, you could put whatever you wanted to put in this little pocket on the back. And then your seam binding just wraps around. And all this is taking, I think I took a 1-inch punch, and I punched out the paper 3 or 4 times, glued it together. You put a hole in the middle for your brad. The brad goes through the front part of this, and the brad goes through that. And then you've got your twisty-do. Over here, I have another piece of chipboard. This is my stopper to keep things from falling out, with the ribbon and two of the little journaling cards. So this is my book, everybody. I hope you like it. I had lots of fun. Graphic 45 never disappoints in their paper lines. They are always so, so gorgeous. Just love them. Possibilities are endless with what you can do with them. And like I said, I don't have a whole lot of the paper left, but I have enough. I'll probably be able to get 10 to 12 cards out of it, I'm thinking. And I will share those when I get done. I don't think I'm going to do the process of how I make the cards, but I will give you hints on different things I've done if there's something that I think might be of interest to you. So there we go. Thanks for watching. Check out the still photos that are to come. Check out my blog, Facebook, and I will leave all the links to Tammy's store, Country Craft Creations, and the Facebook page directly below in the links in the expanded about section below the video. Have a very crafty day. Thank you for joining me. I'll see you next time. Bye, everyone.